Hello and welcome to my creativity room. I am jumping into Photoshop today to show you a really special image. I'm going to edit this one from scratch, and we're going to take a look at how this was put together. I'm really excited for this particular picture because it was one of those really important images in my life that I made that sort of changed how I thought about photography, how I thought about my career, and so I want to dive into this and just take a look at how we can edit this together. My name is Brooke Shaden, I'm a fine art photographer, and I'm so grateful to you for coming on this journey with me. It means everything to me. I'm so thankful. So let's come in here and see what we can do with some editing. This image is called Information and was really inspired by the human body's ability to relate to natural things, in this case fruit. Sometimes I like to do this in relation to mountains or natural shapes that we find in the world. And this particular one was using these apples that I had that I really wanted to utilize. So let's take a look. We've got, there I am in my friend's apartment from yesteryear. This was, 9 years ago now that I shot this. And I was photographing the apples separately so that I could add them into the picture. Here we've got the subject in, and then we've got an apple falling off of the table, which I really wanted to have that natural motion blur. So let's go ahead and just quickly crop this into into the shape that I want, into the square. And the first thing that I know that I need to do is add this apple in. So let's go ahead with the lasso tool and just take that apple, copy it, and paste it, and just stick it right in there. It doesn't have to be any more complicated than that, right? Like, so simple. I'm just gonna put that where I think, oh, it goes over there. I couldn't find the right spot. There it is. Perfect. I can just see a little bit of where I need to erase just to be safe. So let's go ahead, hardness is down, just erase it right through there and there. Perfect. So we've got our apple in, that was really simple. Now let's go ahead and darken the backdrop, which was really important. So I'm going to select right around my subject and the apples and the table and just get this outside edge. That's really what I'm going for here. I'm just gonna select so that we can make the background darker. This is actually really challenging to do. It's not an easy thing to do. And it's really particularly difficult when your subject is the same color as the background. That makes it really tough. So let's go ahead, 30 pixel feather here. And I'm just going into curves and darkening. Okay, now you see what we have here is we have this natural ghosting effect where we feathered the selection, and that is not allowing a natural transition. But we have a layer mask already on that adjustment layer. So let's go in with a small brush on white, there we go, and then just bring back where we didn't allow the effect to go, which would be all around here. And we can let some of it hit the subject. And if this isn't working for you, like it's just not, you're not able to get close enough, it's still ghosting, you can always do this at a lower opacity. But also remember that we have a lot of flexibility here because we're on a layer mask. So whatever we do, we can undo super simply. So I'm just going through and getting where I think it should be. I missed that whole little area in there. Going around the apple. Going around my hand. Okay. Now I can see though that there's too much now on the subject, and this is a really tough balance, but we're gonna get it. So now I'm switching to black so I can erase and taking my opacity down. And I'm just gonna go in along my subject now and see if I can't erase some of where it's just too much on my subject. And this is just a balance, you know, you just try and you try again and you see what works and what doesn't work and see if you can get it to a place that looks more believable than it did before. That's really the goal here. Now, sometimes I get really frustrated with this, so I'll take my brush size up quite a bit, hardness all the way down, opacity down, and I'll just go in and do like a big sweep around the edge, and then again, bringing it back in a big sweep so that it's more of a natural gradient where it hits the body instead of just a stark line. And I tend to do that because it looks a little bit more natural. And same with on the table, like we can bring some back on the table so that it's a more natural gradient. And so what we're doing is we're just darkening that background. And it's really effective, I think. We can see through here maybe to lighten that area. You know, there are so many ways we could go with it, but that's essentially all I'm doing. I'm gonna duplicate my background layer because I wanna get rid of that mirror. Anytime I see something in a background of an image that looks distracting or like it wasn't intentional, I just get rid of it. And that's gonna be really simple with the clone stamp tool, just selecting an area on this really wonderfully blank wall. Exactly what we want for our purposes. We're going to take the brush size down, do this again through here. And I can see I even accidentally clone stamped my back, which isn't good, but I did it, so whatever. Now I'm taking the hardness of my clone stamp up so that I can get really right in along my back there. Good. Now, you can see we've made a mess of it, but we'll just take the brush tool, the healing brush tool, and just smooth it out. So we're just alt-clicking to define a source point, and then just getting rid of whatever's back there. Now, for the sake of time, I'm not going to do a perfect job of that, but there we go. We got rid of the background. That's what it was before. Now, here it is after. Right? And so we've got this image to look at as reference. We can see that it's still, there we are, too bright. And so let's go ahead with our curves and just take that down a little, maybe add a little bit of contrast to it. And when I do that, I think it's too saturated. So let's take the saturation down quite a lot as well. And I think this is turning into a really good spot. Now I would wanna maybe get rid of the acne on the back just a bit so that it's not distracting. So we can do that super, super fast. Just again by defining a source point and getting in there and getting rid of it. So that's really easy, really simple. And so now, the last thing that I really want to focus on here, rather than adding a texture or anything like that, is to make the bones pop in the back. And so let's go in with the dodge tool and see if we can't make those bones pop. So we're going to take our exposure to about 30% on midtones is great. And wherever there's a natural highlight, I'm just going to enhance it. Just enhancing where the highlights already are. And then with the burn tool, exposure to about anywhere in the 20 to 30% range, I'm going to do the same thing. Just going around the other side of the vertebrae now to create this look of like a real 3D popping effect. So you can see what that's done so fast. And if we go to the beginning there, look at that. Like, we're just making this pop because what was 3D looks flattened in an image sometimes. So we're really just letting it shine. We're letting the vertebrae just pop out of the back. And that's going to make a really big difference for us when we do play with how dark we want it, how much we want it to pop, etc. It's just really going to be the center point of the image and also really mimic the fruit that's falling through it. So this was the original one, and we're not going to get there today. There's a lot that we would change, but in just a few minutes, we've made a huge transformation from that to that. And sometimes the way that I like to work best is in these simple ways, using the light that's already there, using the backdrop that's already there, and just really focusing in on what the subject and the theme should be. I really hope that you enjoyed this. I've had such a great time making these videos and getting to bring you into my space to work in the place that I love to work in Photoshop on my computer. And I hope that if anything, it inspires you to please get out there and create because you have a voice and a message that other people need to hear. So please remember that always and forever. Create, 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 no matter what, no matter how weird, and especially if it's weird. Thank you guys.